And how is your fake laugh? Hey Wishki, it's me, Coco Bechamel! Time for yet another episode of me cooking something scrumptious for you! Today, we're making something less colorful, but even sweeter than last time, angel wings! According to the first few lines on Wikipedia, they originated in ancient Rome. Isn't that exciting? My recipe is actually a Polish version known by many names, mostly chrust, chruściki or faworki. If you like cookies and fried stuff, you'll love these, because they're exactly that, fried cookies! It took me a while to perfect my recipe, mostly because of how different American sour cream is, but now my recipe is literally dump-proof. This is a rather small portion, so if you want more, just double or triple the ingredients. Enough talking, let's cook! Start with 1 cup all-purpose flour, add 1 teaspoon baking powder, 1 tablespoon sugar, oh, and a pinch of salt. Mix them with a whisker or a fork. Now it's time for wetting ingredients. 1 teaspoon soft or melted butter, 2 tablespoons sour cream, and 1 tablespoon white vinegar. Instead of vinegar, you may use alcohol, like vodka. 2 yolks. Now start gently mixing all of the ingredients together. I suggest starting with a wooden spoon and then use your fingers. But if you don't fear getting dirty, just dig in! This is actually the most important step. You need to mix and knead the dough really good, at least 10 to 20 minutes. If you wonder why, there are 2 wheat's native proteins, glutenin and gliadin. When they come into contact with water, they form a new protein, gluten. Mixing is essential because it speeds up the hydration process and ensures that water is evenly dispersed throughout the flour. Although hydration happens quickly, it takes time to form the chemical attachments that knit gluten proteins together into a strong network. As mixing continues and the ingredients transform into a dough, the chains of proteins become more numerous and elongated. They organize into a sort of webbings that are both elastic and extensible. These 2 features are what make our angel wings airy and fluffy while frying. And now you know! As with crepes we did last time, the consistency is the key. If the dough keeps sticking to your fingers, add a little more flour. If it's too dry, add a tiny bit of sour cream. Make sure there are no nails or rhinestones in the dough, and you're done! Now, wrap your dough in a plastic wrap and let it sit in the fridge for at least 20 minutes, maybe up to 1 hour. Take it out of the fridge. I cut mine in half, as my biggest cutting board isn't really that big. Roll out the dough, more or less evenly. And then cut it into about 1-inch wide strips. Here's the fun part. The actual shape and size is up to you, within limits of course. I like cutting mine diagonally, like so. Then cut a little slit in each of them. Let's do a little upsy-turvy. Gently pick one up and then twist it by pulling one side through the hole. Do the same thing with all of them. Time for the other half. As I said many times before, Polish recipes differ from household to household. This batch is made Mr. Bechamel style. As you can see, he goes for extremely thin dough, bigger pieces, and they're cut at a different angle. The twisty part is the same. When they're long like this, you can actually twist them twice, but I'm not doing that with those nails. Make sure the oil is really hot. Throw in a little piece of your dough. If it bubbles, it's ready. Start by putting your angel wings inside, few at a time. They will cook really fast, so be ready to rotate and or take them out. We want a nice golden brown color. You can use a long skewer or a fork to move them around. I prefer tongs. When they're done, take them out and put them on a paper towel to dry. Pop, 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 and we're done! Before they fully cool down, sprinkle them with powdered sugar. And now, my favorite part, trying them out! Let's see if they're delicious. And just to be sure, one big one from Mr. Bechamel. See how airy and crunchy these are? I guess you know what I'm going to say, but
they're so simple, yet so scrumptious and delicate. I love them, and I know you will love them too. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed my recipe. Remember to like, subscribe, and follow me on all my social media. I also have some new merchandise, so go in and buy some. Let the dopamine flow. Bye-bye!